Afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni and
Anne-Marie Gianni.
And today is Wednesday. Today we're in the kitchen. We're preparing something very special.
Something special for our younger viewers out there.
Yeah.
We had a few requests lately. One from Leo at the Vibrant Living Expo. Uh-huh. He requested ice pops.
Hey, Leo.
And also from Kai. Kai requested something a long time ago, and I promised him a special show, so this show is for you too, Kai.
Isn't it for a whole list of other people too?
I think so, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, we have a whole lot of younger viewers. We have Justin and Brianna and Brian and Jenna. We have, I feel like that show, there used to be a kids show out there that the lady was looking through a glass. I don't remember. Matt, Secret Garden? I think it's a Secret Garden. She's looking through a glass and saying all the kids' names that she sees in that glass. So, well, who other kids do I see out there? I see Gilbert, and I see Court, and I see Lily and Kai and Baby Weinstein.
I see the list over there, so make sure you don't forget anyone. The Shields family.
The Shields family. I see Noah.
Yeah.
I see Baby Christopher. I don't see him just yet, but he's coming soon.
All right. Let's make it happen.
All right. So like I said, we're making ice pops today, and this is a great after-school snack. So for all you younger viewers, grab your parents and tell them to help you make yummy ice pops.
Great.
We're going to start with coconut.
And please ask your parent to open the coconut for you.
This is a job Mom and Dad can help you with. So, yummy coconut. I'm using berries for this blend.
Okay.
But if your child loves mangoes or bananas or pineapples or grapes, you can use any fruit blend.
Whatever you like.
Whatever you like, but I'm just using berries. So, we have strawberries.
I was tempted to eat all this before it was even a...
I know.
Before it was even an ice pop.
We have blueberries.
Clearly you can just mix this up as a smoothie and just drink it.
Yes, it is very clear. I'm using some raw honey.
Uh-huh.
You can use, you can sweeten it up as you like or as your child likes. I'm putting a tiny, tiny bit of coconut water. Just a tiny bit.
Uh-huh.
Just to get it to blend, and then we'll see if we need more, but I want it to be a pretty thick consistency. And I'm using a secret recipe, or secret ingredient here.
Uh-huh.
No one can see what it is.
Okay.
We'll post it on the blog, though, I promise. Secret ingredient to give you super, super strength.
Yeah, there we go.
I'm gonna pop that lid on top.
All right, let's go.
All right, let's blend them up. Like I said, you want
to... So what's that consistency?
I'm going to keep it pretty thick.
Okay, cool.
Nice and thick.
Great. And the show also goes out to Ellie and Lyle, who are actually going to be able to enjoy these on Thursday.
On Thursday. Definitely. One point, if you guys have picky eaters... well, there's no more blueberries in here.
Right. If you have picky eaters, just give them,
just give them air. Just give them air. What you can do is blend up the berries first and then strain it through a nut milk bag to get all the seeds out, because they might not like the seeds, so strain it through a nut milk bag, and that way you'll get all the seeds out and then blend it with the rest of the ingredients.
Okay.
Some of you might actually have ice pop molds or popsicle molds.
Uh-huh.
I don't. But what you can do is put it in Dixie cups, little paper cups. So again, once you get them all filled up, and stick them in the freezer, you'll stick them in the freezer for about 45 minutes, and then you can stick a popsicle stick, but they might even stand up now. They're pretty thick, so I'm gonna stick them in there now. I'll have to be.
Hmm? Yeah, it's tipping.
Oh. It's just because of me. I'll have to be honest with you guys, I couldn't find popsicle sticks. I was driving around San Diego, and I couldn't find a Party Stop or like a Michael's or any kind of store like that where I was, but I found these bamboo skewers. They had a pointy tip on the end that I just took off and shaved down.
You can use just about anything.
Yeah, and that'll work just fine.
You can even get twigs from outside if you want.
Yeah, why not?
That'd be actually neat.
Mm-hmm.
Just to make sure it's not a toxic plant.
We'll stick them right in there. Oh, let's see if my dish...
Perfect.
It fits. We'll see you when they're frozen. All right, are we ready for our snack?
Nope.
You're not ready for your snack?
Yes, I am. It's going to be good.
I'm ready for my snack.
I wonder if they're frozen. We actually haven't looked at them yet.
Yes, we have.
Oh.
I have.
Emery has. I haven't looked at them.
They are frozen.
Hey, wait a minute. There's one missing.
I've already had one. I had to test it out.
Uh-huh.
They're frozen. All you want to do now is rip the cup and peel it off.
Look at that.
There we go. And a little trick that my mom always had us do.
Oh, what's that?
Is either a napkin... Stuck it through the hole.
Why don't
there.
You just use the cup?
I guess you
so
could.
So we don't use another piece of paper.
You could. Mm-hmm. Or a napkin, or she actually had us take one of those big paper plates. It was a waste, but and stick the whole.
You were that kid at the playground,
yeah,
though.
Center. No, not at a playground. The playground did look messy, but if I was eating it in her house, put it in the center of the plate and hold it like that. So the big plate's all around. So eating it like this, so you only get the juice on the plate.
Awesome.
But there we have it. There's our ice pop.
Great.
I hope you kids enjoy it.
Cool. Did you have something else to talk about?
I do. All right, I do have something to add.
And what do you have to add?
Something to tell you guys.
this wasn't planned.
All of you have been commenting on my skin lately, and I...
And mine too.
Yeah, Kevin's too. Good. We appreciate those comments. And yes, it could be due to the California sunshine. We have been outside more in the sunshine. So that is a big factor. But there's also another factor to it. Kevin and I have been experimenting and playing with new skincare products.
I've been experimenting with skincare products.
Yeah. And he actually is funny because he'll come to me at night and be like, what do you think's best? Well, my skin's a little dry. What should I use on my face? And so I've been working with one of the top formulators in organic spa skincare lines to come out with a nice, clean line for all of you guys and for ourselves. A lot of people have been asking me, and I've wanted something for myself that was really clean and really nourishing for my skin. So we've come up with something that, yes, it's pretty edible. Some of it might not taste very good just because of the mix, but it's food for your skin. And two products that we're starting with, and you guys have probably already seen the emails today, is a honey coconut mask, and it's just really, really moisturizing, really nice. It's also nice on a cucumber or a cracker. Mm-hmm. And also a great body oil. It's a coconut blend with a lot of different herbs in it, too. Body oil that can be used as a massage oil or just an after shower moisturizer.
It smells awesome.
Yeah, and they do. They smell incredible. So I'm really, really excited to present these things to you guys. We'll do some shows next week of me demonstrating them.
When we were at the Vibrant Living Expo, people kept walking by saying, what smells so good at your booth?
Mm-hmm.
And Emery said, it's Kevin. And it really was. Because I had some of the moisturizing stuff on. I smelled pretty.
Uh-huh.
All right, so your question of the day is, what is your favorite popsicle fruit? How about that?
Cool.
Is that a good one?
Mm-hmm.
My favorite popsicle fruit used to be the blue fruit.
The blue fruit?
Yeah, the one that was in those...
like in the rocket ship?
No, yeah, the blue, the white, or the red in the rocket ship and the bomb pop.
Yeah,
or
those are my favorite.
or the ones that are in the plastic, I don't even know what they're called, the plastic frozen tubes.
Those are
I used to tell our personal training clients that if I ever see you eating one of these three things, and one of them, or eating or taking one of these three things, one of them was cigarettes, I was like, you know, this is bad. Diet soda is bad. And then the third thing was anything that's colored that... The coloring could be doubled as a highlighter fluid filler. So those three things were things I said, you know, these are bad. You know, I never really said anything was that bad, but those things are bad. So anyway, your question of the day is, what's your favorite popsicle fruit? Go ahead and post it down below. This is Kevin Gianni and...
Amory Gianni.
Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.